Okay, so I'm going to attempt to make a new Disney ink brush from scratch. So I know the first thing that I have to do when I'm making a brush is I have to make the alpha. So I want it to be like Disney ink, but I want it to be completely solid. But I'm going to make this brush from scratch. I'm not going to use any other brushes as like an initial template, which is what I usually do. Just use a brush that you like, but then just, you know, make it into a brush that really works for you. So let me see if I already made any oval shapes. Because I think that's where I need to start. Okay, so I need to make an oval, which is very simple. That looks all right so far. Okay, middle and middle. Good. I think I might rename this. Oops. Okay, so I made an alpha that I should be able to use. Okay, so this is my new list of brushes that I made and stamp brushes. I think I'm just going to make it here. So new brush. Okay. Okay, so now we can start. So this is the original brush, but I need to bring in my shape. Okay. It's not bad. Okay, stroke path, spacing is at 17. I think I want it to be let's take a look on the canvas. Okay, so it's still a little bit too spaced out. Like an alien movie. So I'm going to put it to none. Okay, that's better. I want it solid. Okay. And I'm just setting the reset point, so this is the point that it won't revert back to, so I can always get back to this brush. Even though I'm just doing little small increments, I just feel like I want to keep track of everything. Okay, I don't think I want any fall off. Stabilization, streamline. It feels pretty good. Feels nice. And you can see I'm actually doing a lot of the shapes that I make. Like, for example, the eyes and things like that. Okay, so I'm going to put this to 60 for now. Stabilization. Let's see what happens if I put it at 15. Okay. Still a little, still very shaky. Oops, I keep forgetting how to get back to the brush. I don't even know what these are. So let's see what happens if I... Well, this one definitely looks better. So I'm going to put expression up to max. Let's see if I put stabilization up. Oh, now I'm seeing some changes. Looks a little better. Let me check on the... Make sure the cat isn't outside in the rain. Okay, I just heard something outside. I want to make sure it's not the cat looking for food. Because it's raining out there, baby. Okay, so grain. I think I do just want to keep solid. Let's take a look at some grains, though. It would be kind of cool to have to do one, like a Disney pencil would be cool. So we'll come back to this. We'll come back to that. Oops. So I'll leave this one blank. Done. Stabilization. Okay. So far so good. But I do want to, let me duplicate this. I just want to create some brushes that are all completely mine from scratch, because I wanted to learn this process and I want to put them on Gumroad and I want to be able to just use them all the time. Very serious about my brushes. Okay, so for I think this one is the Disney pencil. So I might change this as I get further along with Disney ink, but for now I think I want the size to affect the brush, and I want the grain on this one to be pastel paper. Okay, so I'll work on this one a little bit later. Gotta find a mute button. Alright. So let me go back to Disney Ink. So that was good. I did want also... I noticed that when I went to... Apple Pencil, pressure was actually what I wanted. We're actually getting very close to what I want. It looks pretty good, but I don't want the end to be, I don't want the pressure to affect the end of the brush. So if I take that opacity away, I think that might do it. Okay, good. So I took that opacity away. So that's good. Flow, I don't know what flow means. We'll try it at max. It's kind of cool. It'd be kind of cool as like smoke. So I'm going to make derivatives of these brushes, so that's why I keep making changes like this. What? Okay, so I can take the flow away. Bleed? That looks really nice. Let's see how that actually looks. Oh, I'm drawing really small. Okay, so I noticed the brush is very small. Maximum size is set to pretty big. Apple Pencil. Pressure. Flow. Bleed. So right now I have it at 11. Let's put it at 100%. I just want to see what happens. Back to 11. So notice the tip is also much bigger now. Make sure it's not because I'm drawing. Okay, so it is a little bit the pressure. I must have been putting a little more pressure on it. Tilt is at 9. Size compression. Let's see what size compression. That looks pretty good. I notice size compression was turned off. Now it's on. I don't really notice much of a difference. So I'll leave it off for now. Dynamics. I don't think I want the speed to... What does that do? Do I want any of that? Jitter. I think I want to keep it clean. So I'll put this jitter to none. Color dynamics. I don't really think I need to do any of that, but that'd be fun to do like a Disney color. Rendering. I think this is fine. Uniform glaze. Intense. I don't see any difference to any of these. Intense blending. So I'm probably not doing that right, is my guess. So I'm just going to leave it at intense. Burnt edges. So I like my barbecue. Grain source. So we want to keep this normal. Grain filtering. I don't really think we have grain, so I think that's fine. Ooh, there we go. That's good. Keep that down as a muth. But let me get some water. Okay, got some water. Some water. I should be all right. Okay, that looks good. But I'm noticing that the tip isn't the same anymore. Okay. Bleed is at 11. Let's see if that makes any difference here. So leave it at 11. So as I'm making these changes, I just want to go back and make sure that something I haven't adjusted earlier affects it too much. Sarah, I hate when I swallow. I hate swallow. I don't know why I swallow so loud. I think it's just because the mic is here and I'm in my own head. Okay. So this is all looking very nice so far. I want to streamline it a bit more. That feels nice. Stabilization at 40. That actually feels nice too. So I got to figure out how to make this thing taper. always had problems with that pressure. Okay, so there's regular taper. Okay, nothing. That end is so weird. Oh, that's pretty good so far. I can definitely work with that. I can definitely work with that. Okay. Oh. Again, I keep forgetting to go back into my brushes. Okay, so now I'm pretty happy with that, but I don't know what this does. Tip. It'd be kind of cool if the front tip could be smaller. No, I think that was the opposite. Tip animation. Let's see if we want tip animation. I don't know what this shape is I keep making, but it just feels right. Now I forgot how to do it. That looks good. Touch taper. See, I don't know what. What does touch taper mean? Now, what is the difference? You know, I should have left it. Hold on. Let me pull out this Aoki. I actually do find this thing to be quite useful sometimes. When I don't want to, like, go all the way up there. I know it seems far, but I know I could use this hand, but I have my little plant there. My little faux plant. And here I can just, you know. Touch taper. So let's see if I turn touch taper off. Why does it look like this is darker than that? Does it still look like that? No, I think it's just the angle that I'm viewing the iPad. I don't really see any difference, though. It's hard because I want to make sure that I'm making the same So I think I like with touch taper, right? Is that the one I liked? Okay, I think I like with touch taper. Size. What is the size? Tip. Sharp. Classic taper. I like this taper, but I just wish that classic taper. Actually looks good. Oh, why does it leave that thing there? That would be perfect without that. Maybe that's the touch taper. Let's see. Let's see what happens if I take it off. Okay. So I like classic taper. Let's see if we turn it off touch taper. I don't know how to get rid of that thing. Okay, so I think I like to pressure up higher. Man, these would look so nice if that one little tip. Oh, all of a sudden it's just there all the time now. Okay, so let's see when it shows up. Shows up. Okay, so now it showed up again. Maybe I need to turn off touch taper. Okay, so it looks like I have to turn off touch taper. Which is a shame because it looked really nice. I feel like it doesn't give me an accurate. And then classic, I think, gives me that little spurt at the end, at the beginning. Okay, well, I'm really happy with this, so let me go ahead and save this. Okay, I'm very happy. I can work with this brush already. Brush properties. I think I'm happy with this. See if I can do some line work with it. I'd say I'm pretty happy with it. Let me use my other brush. Okay. Actually, drawing really small. I think that edge looks nice. I think I'm happy with it. Okay, so that's very thick. I think it might actually be able to use a little more. Streamline is up high. See what happens if I do stabilization at 50. That actually looks quite nice. Yeah, that feels good. Okay, I'm very, very happy with this brush, actually. I think that's good. Procreate pencil. See how that is if I wanted to write my signature. Okay, so for the pencil, I don't think I want the tips to be. There can be a little movement, I think. Stroke path, jitter. There definitely should be a little bit of jitter, I think. Maybe a little less. Fall off. A little more fall off, maybe. Well, that actually feels really nice. But maybe turn the pressure down. Can probably turn the streamline down a little bit. Let me see. It's actually not really. Feels pretty good, actually. Maybe 25. So this was at 60%. I want it to be very, very fluid. I think that feels good. This the way that it reacts though is a bit weird. Let's see what it's like with classic tapering. And classic tapering works better. Maybe just a little bit for the tip. maybe a little bit for the end too. All right. Maybe that's better. So we'll try it at 50. Try it at 100 and see what the difference is. Feels really good, actually. Burnt edges, like my barbecue. Luminance blending. Can't tell the difference. Blend mode. Right now it's in normal. Let's see. Ooh, that's very dark. Well, that's really nice though. One thing that's important to me about a pencil is I do want to be able to softly fill in a line. Now, I'm not sure exactly how to do that. Let's see what uniform glaze does. Uniform blending. So I want to be able to like sketch an eye, color it in. Oh, that looks quite nice, actually. So that's uniform blending. Let's see if it really made a difference, if I could do the same thing. So I can do the same thing with that. If I lower the opacity a little bit. That is nice, but I think I might like the uniform blending better, actually. It's a little lighter, which is something I like. Turn these off. Long light, 47 minutes. I'm really working hard here. Burnt edges mode. Let's put it on max and see what that actually does. Spelled it wrong. No, I didn't. I don't think that adds anything to it, so I'm going to put it back down to zero. Okay, I like uniform blending. Charge is at 50. I don't know what that is. Pull is at 75. Doesn't seem like it's doing much. Color dynamics. Dynamics. Speed. I don't want the size to get bigger with speed. Opacity? I think that's fine how it is. Flows at zero. Bleed? Ooh. Properties, maximum size, that's fine. Materials, about this brush. I think I'm happy with it. I'm really excited to sketch with these brushes. Like, this is so exciting. I gave him two sets of eyelashes. It's nice. I can keep that nice and dark. I feel like I could probably lighten it up a little bit. It's the only thing feel like I might be able to lighten it up a little bit. So what's the best way to lighten it up a little bit? Pressure, opacity. Okay, so that has to be all the way up. Flow. Dynamics. Maximum opacity. What if I bring that down to 75? I wonder if no, I don't like that at all. Maximum opacity. Grain. Texturizer. Oh, I see. Classic filtering. Let's see the difference. Classic versus improved. Oh, I think they're the same. Fall off? No, I don't think it's fall off. Fall off is 14. If I put it to 20. Yeah. I guess at least spell fall off right. What did I have it at? 14? No, I do want a little more fall off. Okay. So I'm going to set that back to 14. Dynamics. So let's set this to 50 or 46. Close enough. I don't like the way that color's in, though. It's the only thing. I don't even know where I reset this. Let's reset this brush. that's better. Been drawing so many seahorses lately. Okay, I think I'm happy with this brush. I really think I like it. Sketches look nice and dynamic. Happy with it. So, I need to figure out what I want to make for my avatar. I should just use my snails. Yeah, I should use my snails. So, where are my snails? I think they're in Drive. Drive. Media inserts. PNGs. There's got to be a way that I can just save it to my files. Oh, send a copy, right? And then you have to save it? That's right, I forgot. Apple makes it tricky. They're so tricksy. Okay, so you know what I'm going to do? Disney Pencil. From Photos. Yes, there we go. Disney Ink 2. Oop. Oop. From Photos. And I'll add this even though I didn't finish it yet. Okay, awesome. This is not the best brush for all of a sudden. That's crazy. Why is it so? Let me just streamline this way less. Stabilization. Okay. I should do my signature with this anyway. That looks great for a pencil. All right, cool. I'm happy with them. Disney ink, Disney pencil, done. Obviously, I can't scribble with this because of the fall off, but I think it will work well for when I'm doing line work. And I actually can use it the way it's intended to be used. Yeah, that'll work just fine. Nice and thick up top. Yeah, this is exactly how I wanted it to be. I wish I could have made his little round little tail. Oh yeah, that looks really great. I'm happy. All right. Disney ink made in the books. New Disney ink made by me. And new sketch brush made by me. I'm very excited about these. I'm stretching. Sorry. All right, keep drawing. Hopefully I'll have a couple other brushes. Maybe not a bunch. Maybe like 10 brushes. Different brushes, new brushes. I'll put them on Gumroad. Hope you guys have learned something. If not, hope you guys just enjoyed me going through my process. Keep drawing, and I will catch you all in the next video. Thank you so much for watching the video. I really appreciate you. Be sure to like and subscribe. Follow me on Instagram at DrugFreeDave. And don't forget to join my private Facebook group, Procreate Tutorials and Guidance. Check me out on Facebook. Hopefully I'll see you guys soon. And as always, keep drawing, and I'll see you in the next video.